city seen as a silent powerhouse in the Mumbai metropolitan region. From its rich history to its growing economic significance, Thane is an epicenter of the Shiv Sena's legacy battle. The 20th November election will be the ultimate decider of the Sena versus Sena battle. The most intense fights between Eknath Shinde's and Uddhav Thackeray's factions is in the Thane, Konkan and Mumbai metropolitan region. In 2019, of the 75 seats in this region, the undivided Shiv Sena won 29, while its partner, the BJP, bagged 27 seats, taking the overall NDA tally to 56. It's 10 a.m. and this group of senior citizens in Panch Pakhari area are about to go home after their chai and gupshup post the morning walk. 75-year-old T.P. Bendre, a retired SBI officer, and 87-year-old Madhukar Rajgadkar, a former IT official, are concerned about rising corruption. What are your thoughts about this election?
Candidate should be competent enough, and he should take the entire care of the Thane city, cleanliness. Actually, Thane is keeping cleanliness in a good form, that is true, but transportation is bad. And we want such a candidate who will look to the multi-sided development of Thane.
Okay, so that's your concern about the development of the city in terms of cleanliness.
Yes.
What are your concerns?
My concern is we should have a stable government. It should not hanky-panky for some time these people, some time other people. It should be firm government and which will looking for the development of the, not only the city, India. And it should become number one in the world. India should be number one in the world.
You are of the opinion that stability is key.
Stability.
A government should complete full 5 years in office.
Exactly. Definitely. 5 years they should complete and it should be seen should be that like that it is very much different from today. We should be the number one in the world. That he should take this government as well as the other government in the center. Both should be work in hand and should take India to the first stage.
And you know, those who have seen several summers and winters, what change do you see from the past to now?
Only we should not talk about past. The government should say that what they are going to do, what they have done. Previous government, abusing previous government is a fashion nowadays of a political person. Or whatever it is, it comes to the common citizen also. He will also say that this my senior has not done this thing. And what you are going to do, do it. No, why? How you are abusing, by abusing previous people or past people, you are not going to progress and you are not going to do any service to the government. You see first your stability, what you can do for the people, not by only giving promises. Nowadays we have seen all these promises in during election period, every party is giving. This is all nonsense. Nothing will be materialized by them.
We want honest, sincere and competent representatives.
Right from 51 election, I have opportunity to say I was a child at that time, but I have seen the 51 election. And I am 37 born. I know what was the first election of India. And what were the people those days, what they have done, they have not done for their own. They have done for the nation. Whatever they have done, wrong or right. And their aim was that only, in the freedom. What these people contributed so far for the nation, they should compare with them. Not that by simply abusing, you cannot compare yourself or prove yourself.
Definitely I am not agreeing with him. Because see the railway network that time, it is today. Today we have 100% electricity, electrified railway tracks are there. And so a lot of development is taken for the infrastructure also. But see the, you will find a lot of change from 2014. And definitely it is there.
Prepared by them. Base was somebody is foundation is who did foundation.
फाउंड फाउंडेशन में क्या इफ यू टेक द कुमार का ले लेंगे तो एक मिट्टी बनाता है, लेकिन उसके ऊपर जो बनाता है तो बाद में तो बाकी सब्सिक्वेंटली सम अदर पीपल डू. और इफ देर आर स्टेजेस इनिशियल स्टेज इज देर ओके जस्ट मेकिंग दैट द क्ले, बट उसका पॉट बनाने का तो दूसरा करता है कि उसका डिफरेंट स्टेज इज देर. सो नो डाउट दे हैव डन, but further take people have taken development to the topper level. See what today India is there, see there are lot of efforts of these people also is there. So without these efforts you can't say ki ne only the old people have done. Definitely their contribution is there, but doesn't matter that
their
these people have not.
It was selfless and sacrifice was there. Nowadays sacrification is less and this taking credit is more.
Previous governments have shown the strides of progress, that one has to accept it.
And basic progress, what amenities were prepared by them, the foundation was made by them, then only how many hill stations are, as I say, the Britishers, they also not done. India may, how many hill stations are available, all they are
done by Britishers.
What? Nor the previous people nor these people have done.
That's all.
बताओ होगा तो एक आधा आप बताइए.
हिल स्टेशन अगर लेटेस्ट पीपल हैव डन, लवासा इज द वन ऑफ द एग्जांपल.
ओनली इंडियन पीपल हैव डन व्हाट एवर इट इज, इट मे बी रॉन्ग. लवासा इज द ओनली व्हाट ही सेज आई एग्री. लवासा इज द ओनली वन हु हैज बीन डन बाय दिस न्यू एंशिएंट पीपल.
सो ओवरऑल सीनियर सिटीजन सीम्स टू बी हैप्पी, और आर यू वरीड अबाउट द फ्यूचर ऑफ द कंट्री?
Future is good, provided there is change in
leadership.
Leadership, as a manat nahi bhi, and leadership is already there. But a corrupt leadership, corruption is along with Indian blood. It is in the Indian.
Corruption is rampant.
Thane is the stronghold of Maharashtra Chief Minister Eknath Shinde, who broke away from the Uddhav Thackeray-led Shiv Sena in 2022. Shinde's personal influence in the Thane district cannot be missed. He is an MLA from the Khopri Panch Pakhari constituency. His political journey began here in 1997 when he was elected to the Thane Municipal Corporation. In 2001, he became the Sena leader in the corporation. Shinde was soon deputed for the party's work across Thane, which helped him build a base in this region. In 2001, after the death of his mentor Anand Dighe in a road accident, Shinde took charge of this entire belt. He was elected to the Maharashtra Assembly for the first time in 2004. Today, his mentor's nephew, Kedar Dighe, is his challenger in Khopri Panch Pakhari. A commerce graduate from Mumbai University, 44-year-old Kedar Dighe worked as a data analyst with several multinational companies for 14 years before venturing into politics. We meet Kedar Dighe at his campaign office. With Shivaji statue and a mashal, the Uddhav Thackeray Sena symbol, firmly on display, Dighe says the election is about local issues.
Mr. Kedar Dighe, it's a fascinating contest which is playing out. You're taking on the chief minister. If I may ask you, what made you enter the electoral fray? Because you're also, this is your political and electoral debut.
True. So I belong to a party whereby we just understand the decision from our Uddhav Saab Thackeray, who is the party chief. And once he gives a decision, we need to follow it. We are the true Sainiks who understand only that thing. And that's the reason if with his years of experience, Uddhav Saab, if he is giving such a decision, that means he thinks that I am capable enough to handle this particular situation and this particular constituency. So I believe I respect that decision and going to fight around.
How has the battle been so far?
Wonderful. Because the thing is, the people are absolutely blessing. They have been very close to Dighe Saab for all this time. There have been very elderly people who think that the Dighe name is coming back. And I believe that with their blessings, this would be really successful.
But the Chief Minister, Mr. Eknath Shinde, actually considers Anand Dighe as his political guru, political mentor.
True. So I respect that situation. I respect his decision. But the thing is, see, there needs to be a change. Okay. If you see 147 Khopri Pachpakhadi, the complete constituency, when we are fighting for an election, okay, or when we are contesting an election, you need to see what change you can make in that particular constituency. If you see the past 15-20 years, there have been no change except the road has been widened enough. There have been beautification, nothing else, but that has not changed the common man's life. So there is an issue and which I need to address it.
I was told that, you know, I've been interacting with some people here and they say that Varsha has become, you know, the Chief Minister's home has become very accessible to the common man, which was not the case when Uddhav Thackeray was the Chief Minister.
See, when a company's president rules a company, okay, he appoints directors, he appoints vice presidents, associate vice presidents, general managers, managers. So everyone has been given a portfolio and you need to address those issues at their local portfolio, what you have been given. The same way Uddhav Saab used to do it, he used to run in a right way. But at the same time, when the crisis situation is there, if you see the COVID thing, he was with the common public. Though the Delhi government was saying that you can't meet, you can't give the best of the solutions what Maharashtra government has given during the Uddhav Saab's regime, he was there to take care of the people and that clears out a solution for each and everyone. So I believe that just for the sake of saying that I am meeting people, what change you are going to do? If you see this particular constituency where he himself is from this constituency for past 15 years, you need to ask these people or you need to actually see what is going in the internal side of this constituency. People are in trouble. They have not got with the basic amenities what they need used to get. So there is enough problems. I believe that we should address that.
You know, taking on a chief minister in any election is a tough ask. You have decided to get into this battle. But the larger question is that here is a chief minister who is trying to settle the larger legacy debate also of the Shiv Sena, that he is the real legacy of Balasaheb Thackeray.
So let him do it. See, people has to understand. If he says, see, past 3 years back, if you check, he was saying that he himself is the Shiv Sena. If he wanted to actually show the people or he was against the ideas of Uddhav Saab or the Shiv Sena or the leaders of Shiv Sena, he should have started with his own party. He tried to take away the symbol. He tried to take away the party name. And what else? Other than this, people benefited, people helped our party. If you see the Lok Sabha election, people have voted for us. People have always supported us. The party workers are there with the original Shiv Sena. The leaders have gone with him. So that doesn't make a difference.
The battle for Thane is intense, with both factions leaving no stone unturned. The outcome will determine the fate of Shiv Sena and Maharashtra's politics, as this is crucial for Sena's identity and survival. 79-year-old Vilas Rao Joshi was a close aide of Anand Dighe. We meet him in Anand Ashram in Thane. He says the Asli Sena is the more accessible Sena.
आप किस शिव सेना के साथ हैं आज?
जो हिंदुत्व को मानने वाली शिवसेना है, बाला साहब की शिवसेना है, जो अभी जिसके प्रमुख है हमारे एकनाथ शिंदे जी, उनकी शिवसेना में मैं हूँ, वहाँ का वही काम करता हूँ।
केदार दिघे, who is taking on the chief minister, how do you look at that battle?
I'm very sure एकनाथ शिंदे साहब ये कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी से 2004 में जो डिलिमिटेशन के पहले इट वाज 2004 वहाँ से लेके अब तक एकनाथ शिंदे साहब हर बार चुन के आए, भारी वोटों से चुन के आए, तो मुझे नहीं लगता है कि अभी कुछ ऑन द कंट्री मुझे लगता है कि इस बार तो महाराष्ट्र में एकनाथ शिंदे साहब रिकॉर्ड बना देंगे। सबसे ज़्यादा भारी मतों से जीतने वाला उम्मीदवार एकनाथ शिंदे साहब हो गए, ऐसा मुझे पूरा विश्वास है।
You know, as someone who has worked with Anand Dighe, do you think he would have been disappointed because Kedar Dighe is contesting?
I don't think so. Not at all. बिकॉज दिघे साहब का नेचर ऐसा था कि जो काम करने वाला व्यक्ति है वो कौन से भी पद में हो उसको अच्छी तरह से कहते थे कि तू आगे बढ़, मैं तुम्हारे साथ में हूँ। और एज़ फार एज जो एकनाथ शिंदे साहब को उन्होंने जो उनके साथ देखा है काम करते हुए, मैंने दिघे साहब के साथ में, वो नगर सेवक थे, सभागृह नेते थे, बाद में 2004 में वो पहले विधायक बन गए। तो जो दिघे साहब को और बाला साहब ठाकरे साहब को जो अपेक्षित था, जिस तरह से काम करना चाहिए, 80% समाज सेवा और 20% राजकारण, ये जो हमारा थीम है बेसिकली शिवसेना का, उसको लगातार उसी तरह से एकनाथ शिंदे साहब और हम सब लोग जो है उनके आदेश पर काम करते हैं। तो दिघे साहब वुड हैव बीन वेरी हैप्पी, उनका आशीर्वाद है उनको, बाला साहब ठाकरे साहब का भी उनको आशीर्वाद है एकनाथ शिंदे साहब को।
शिवसेना वॉज स्प्लिट इन टू पार्ट्स, वन ऑफ उद्धव ठाकरे, अनदर वन ऑफ एकनाथ शिंदे। इट वॉज सेड दैट द रियल लेगेसी ऑफ बाला साहेब ठाकरे कैन ओनली बी अ ठाकरे।
नॉट नेसेसरली, ठाकरे साहब जब थे, बाला साहब ठाकरे, उन्होंने कभी कोई अच्छा पद ग्रहण, चीफ मिनिस्टरशिप वगैरह कभी ली नहीं थी ना, उन्होंने हमेशा दूसरों को आगे किया था, तू अच्छा काम कर रहा है तू चीफ मिनिस्टर बन। राणे साहब और मनोहर जोशी साहब, उनको किसने चीफ मिनिस्टरशिप दी थी महाराष्ट्र की, उन्होंने दूसरे को ही दी ना। तो ऐसा ही ये एकनाथ शिंदे साहब का नाम तय हो गया था उस समय, लेकिन बाद में अंतर्गत कुछ रीजंस है उसकी वजह से उनको नहीं मिला। लेकिन देखो, भगवान दिघे साहब का आशीर्वाद और बाला साहब जी का आशीर्वाद उनके पास था, अब चीफ मिनिस्टर बन गए। और 2.5 साल अप्रोक्सीमेटली जो पीरियड है उसमें उन्होंने जो अच्छा काम करके बताया, विविध योजनाएँ उन्होंने कार्यान्वित की, इम्प्लीमेंटेशन अच्छी तरह से हो गया, लोग उनके साथ है, पूरा महाराष्ट्र उनको अभी अच्छी तरह से जानता है और उनको भाता भी है कि मैं यही अच्छा आदमी है। बिकॉज ही सेज कि मैं चीफ मिनिस्टर सीएम नहीं हूँ, मैं कॉमन मैन हूँ। और अभी भी देखो,
मराठी मानुष
तो है लेकिन सभी जाति धर्मों में वो बहुत अच्छी तरह से लोकप्रिय है, यह उनकी खासियत है।
History has it that every time Shiv Sena faced rebellion, Eknath Shinde countered it vigorously. In 2005, when Narayan Rane's men took on Shiv Senics after his defection to the Congress, Shinde bolstered the party ranks. Sena's dependence on Eknath Shinde increased when Sena founder Bal Thackeray's nephew Raj Thackeray quit the party and launched Maharashtra Nav Nirman Sena in 2006. When Sena snapped its 25-year-old alliance with the BJP and contested the assembly polls on its own, Shinde became the leader of the opposition. When Sena joined the BJP-led government, he became the Minister for Public Works. When the Mahavikas Agadi government came to power, Eknath Shinde played a role in bringing some MLAs around. He was often seen as party's troubleshooter. That's why his rebellion came as a bolt from the blue for Uddhav Thackeray, who called it a betrayal.
त्या वेळेला आपल्या शिवसेनेमध्ये गद्दारांनी गद्दारी केली, वय गद्दारच गद्दारच म्हणणार, कारण मंत्रीपद तुमच्या बुडाला चिकटलेली जरी असली ती काही काळापुरती आहेत, पण कपाळावरती गद्दारीचा शिक्का या जन्मी तरी पुसून पुसता येणार नाही, पुसायचा म्हटलं तरी पुसता येणार नाही। गद्दार वाईट एका गोष्टीचं वाटतं आणि संतापही एका गोष्टीचा येतो की जेव्हा मी माझ्या शस्त्रक्रियेसाठी हॉस्पिटलमध्ये होतो, मी बोललो नाही तुमच्याशी, माझी बोट सुद्धा हालत नव्हती, शरीर पूर्णपणे निश्चल पडलं होतं। त्यावेळेला ज्यांच्यावरती मी जबाबदारी दिली होती ते कटाप्पा, हो कटाप्पा म्हणजे जे कट करणारे अप्पा, ते कटाप्पा।
कोणी केली गद्दारी? तुम्ही केली गद्दारी, आम्ही गद्दार नाही, तुम्ही गद्दार आहात. आणि म्हणून जनतेने ठरवलंय गद्दारांना साथ द्यायची की बाळासाहेबांच्या शिलेदारांना साथ द्यायची.
In the last 2 years, Thane has seen a sudden increase in development projects. Dr. Mahesh Bedekar has filed 5 PILs in the last few years. His fight has been against the builder lobby encroaching upon open spaces. He says redevelopment is a key issue here. What are the issues and concerns of a citizen such as you?
So, I have been staying in Thane for about now more than 50 years now. And I personally feel the urban mess which we have been seeing in all other cities of Mumbai or other states, I think that is a major thing which unfortunately we have seen in Thane. Because Thane grew in last 25 years, there was huge influx of population coming from Mumbai because Mumbai was very costly. So Thane that way was a cheaper option for those people. So infrastructure, if you ask me, tall high-rise buildings came up like anything. This is a very big, I should say, residential hub today. But the infrastructure development which was expected in comparison to that, that has not happened. Because the influx of cars which are coming in and the traffic which we are unfortunately seeing today, going to one place from other place, it used to take about 10 minutes, today it takes an hour. So that is a major thing which we are seeing. Fortunately, our roads have become wide, but they are not at all. We cannot compare it with the influx which is coming and the infrastructure which we have provided. Second thing, public transport. Unfortunately, I have seen and I have been an advocate of that giving more parking spaces is never a solution. We have to have good public transport. People cannot bring more cars into the city. If they bring more cars, if you give them more parking, they will bring more cars. And that circle is not going to break. We have to see to it that less cars are coming into the city because economically we are growing. Everybody wants 2 cars, 3 cars. That amount of infrastructure development is not going to happen.
Okay, and Mahesh, you know, the larger question is also that has there been some sudden increase in developments, particularly after Eknath Shinde, because he is from Thane.
Yeah. See, I'll tell you, there is a change.
There is a change.
I should accept that. I have been always critical about the establishment, if you ask me, because I ask questions. As an educated person, I think I should ask questions. There is a change in healthcare and some amount of education, because we had only 2 hospitals in Thane, but now in this 2 or 3 years, I have seen public hospitals coming in a big way. That is very important. As a doctor, I have a private practice. All cannot afford my hospital, and that was a huge need. We had only 2 public hospitals. Today there are 3 to 4 more public hospitals which are giving very good service for common man. I am talking about common mans like laborers or those who work in our places. So that is a very good change which has happened. As far as education is concerned, yes, we are into education, but there are few good government schools which are coming in Thane. That 2 things and the metro connectivity, which I have seen in least 3 years or 2.5 years, the metro work which was happening in a snail pace, now in these 2 years.
So it's essentially the benefits of being the chief minister's constituency.
Yes, yes. Our roads have, we were known for having potholes. In these 2 years, we have not seen potholes in any monsoons which we had. So there is a change. I should not say that there is, but hopefully it continues, not because we have a chief minister. Hopefully this change continues in future as well.
For Surabhi Thosar, an assistant professor at a local college, the biggest concern is the conservation of lakes in Thane. The city of lakes is surrounded by 35 lakes. So Surabhi, a huge task for you?
Yes. So initially, if we say about lakes, so there were around 60 plus lakes in Thane. But now because of some, you know, construction and other purposes, now the 43 lakes are remaining and we are trying to conserve those lakes. So I am a part of an organization called as Paryavaran Dakshata Mandal. So we are working in this field of environment since last 25 years. And with the Thane Municipal Corporation, we have started this campaign called as My Lake Campaign.
Things improved because now it's a chief minister's constituency?
Yeah, we can say like some of the things have improved, and our volunteers are also there. Like we have 300 plus volunteers. They're working in this field very actively. So mostly like we see some positive things, but there are some negative things as well. Like still there are like people throw food for fishes in the lakes. Nirmalya, we know, like we use for God, so that also people sometimes throw inside the lake. So there is like both the sides are there.
The Shiv Sena, once a formidable force in Maharashtra politics, is now embroiled in a bitter internal battle. Founded by Bal Thackeray in 1966, Shiv Sena emerged as a champion of Marathi pride and Hindutva. Thackeray popularized the term Marathi Manus, emphasizing on the need to protect Maharashtrian interests and culture. The Marathi Manus today stands at crossroads. The results of 23rd will decide his future.